2,000 assists!
Hey, yo, I'ma start it off first.
I inspired Direct from Grind Time to start up his shit.
Dude, I party like a rock star.
Then came King of the Dot, URL, and all the other leagues in this bitch.
I am King of the Dot. My name's embedded in that shit. A legendary status you will never establish.
I put in classic after classic, 10 years in a row.
I'm a legend, dog. Demigod on a whole nother echelon.
Such an aura, an icon, that the limelight always shines on.
It's like the kind of dude that made me want to be better in every avenue, especially like once the fatherhood chapter of his life began. I looked up to him so much as a dad. It made me want to be that superhero more than anything. I mean, and then like the impact that the guy had on our culture, battling alone. He was such a real friend. The guy was just all the way around one of one, man. I could go on and on.
So the first time I ever saw a Pat Stay battle, it was when I was in the Jump Off World Rap Championships in 2007. And simultaneously, the Elements League in Nova Scotia was starting up. And that's where Pat like first initially made his name. And people have talked about this, but I still don't think it's talked about enough. That was the first written league. That it wasn't Smack. It wasn't King of the Dot. It wasn't Grind Time. The Elements League is what gave us the modern battle rap format. And Pat was the star of that league. He was just so fully formed from the beginning that he instantly became someone I looked up to, even though we were the same age and kind of both getting in the game around the same time. And yeah, he was just, to me, he was, as a performer, he was the pinnacle that I knew I could never achieve, but would always be better for chasing. And as a person, he was the most larger-than-life person that I've ever met. That was Pat, man. You know, there's a reason why he was just Pat Stay. That's his real name, because that's just who he was.
The importance of having Twist on this card, I think, is, like, vitally important. And then he and I having the history we do, it's the first King of the Dot champion and the first American King of the Dot champion. We obviously have a WRC and Scribble Jam past. We sort of were on like almost a parallel run with each other and somehow never battled in the written era. So it's really cool for this moment to bring him back, what, 7 years later now or something like that.
Pete, it's been a long time. I remember meeting you 2007 outside the World Rap Championship playoffs in New York. There's a lot of things that I have to say to you that have built up over the years. I thought about what I was going to do tonight. I questioned whether I should say some of these things, but this is for Pat. Pat never pulled a punch in his life. Neither will I. See you soon.
Yo, King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is. We here live, Toronto, stay forever. Make some noise for Pat, y'all. Yeah. We closing out the weekend with this one. It's a very special battle between two of my really close friends. With that being said, former King of the Dot champion to my right, introduce yourself.
What's good, Toronto Thesaurus? It's good to be back. I am so appreciative to be a part of this event, to be back in this city for the first time in 5 years. Long live my brother, the legendary Pat Stay, man.
Former King of the Dot champion, Toronto battle rap legend, to my left, introduce yourself.
Kid fucking Twist!
I know.
That's long live the king. Long live the king.
When I say Pasté, y'all say rest in peace, Pasté.
Rest in peace.
Pasté.
Rest in peace.
Pasté.
Rest in peace.
Let's go. Kid, the source chose to go first. It's on him. Let's get it. Stay forever.
Rest in peace, Pasté. I still speak to my brother often. First Bender, then you. All the losses become exhausting. To get my mind back into battle mode, I had to turn to other options because y'all's battles always inspired me the most, but it still hurts too much to watch them. But making y'all proud's what I want because I know my bros are watching, so I won't let the emotion of both your losses hold me hostage. And my growth is largely the result of what you both accomplished, so I know putting my best foot forward's the only option. Welcome back, Twist. Kind of feels like we did this before. Back to when I kicked in the door and revolutionized an industry for you bitches here more than Christian Dior. Yeah, there was a time when this city was yours, but Twist, that was back in the day when we were young. You're not a kid anymore. Sure, I had two opponents duck. And if you ask me, both were shook. But this is an infinitely better battle, and that should not go overlooked. But you disappeared from our scene for years. And while I respect the road you took, it's time for the guy who wrote the movie to meet the guy who wrote the book. Back in Jeopardy. Choose any subject. I got him sweating like he's watching Cops. Did you touch my drum set? One punch, turn his face, every hue of a sunset. I wanted the best Twist. This ain't the usual suspect. And that's the perfect segue to cue the scene for this. Once upon a time, you flew to Hollywood and flew out to pursue your dreams a bit and wrote a movie loosely based around some useless piece of shit. Maybe it would have made more than 6 cents if you produced a decent script. He tried to get out, causing the descent into a deep abyss. And that's where old boy saw the signs of where the root of evil lives. Now it's 7 years you've been gone, girl. I don't think you were even missed.
Oh my God.
Now it's 7 years you've been gone, girl. I don't think you were even missed. He don't have the prestige like us, which shows y'all the illusionist he is. But my arrival was the inception for why this human being exists. So he'll hold this L as a memento for as soon as he forgets. You were always getting bodied. I just chose to do a scheme like this in case the viewers need a list of better movies with a twist. My bad.
It's funny. I wasn't hearing all that hate when you got paid to cameo.
Wow. You got a point.
I wasn't hearing all that hate when you got paid to cameo. Now I make 6 figures off scripts and you can't even get paid from Cameo. You've been doing this for 20 years, around the world, never slowing your pace. And in those hundreds of battles, you'd think someone would have mentioned all the holes in your face.
Crazy.
No one ever has. It's crazy.
Love it.
You've been doing this for 20 years, around the world, never slowing your pace. And in those hundreds of battles, you'd think someone would have mentioned all the holes in your face. No one ever has. It's crazy. They're all over the place. The fact none of you guys brought this up is a total disgrace. But I will.
Yeah! About time.
Because it's hard to face a legend when he has a face from legends. It takes... It's hard to face a legend when he has a face from legends. It takes 4 hours to get this look for Colin Farrell to play the Penguin.
That's fire.
What?
That's
your
fire.
Face looks like you put a spare tire in an air fryer.
How has that not been said?
Your face looks like you this? Put a spare tire in an air fryer. Or got in a bear fight, then stitched it up with a pair of pliers and snare wire, then went to the gym and fell face first on the stair climber. Your career is a conspiracy by big skincare to drive their shares higher. And he still thinks using face jokes about him is whack. Aren't you keeping up with fashion? The 2000s are back!
Yeah. Okay.
All right, look. I'll be honest. Your face has actually cleared up a lot.
Thanks, Doug. You know.
I just thought that'd be a fun concept to tackle. Was I supposed to do personals on my friend like he's a monstrous asshole? Or call my inspiration bad at rapping like I don't walk in his shadow? I had no way to beat him till I found the one possible angle. Turn this to a compliment battle.
What?
You are top five, no debating.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Nice twist.
Facts! Facts!
Nice twist. You are top five, no debating.
Talk.
We can't deny the facts. Gave us the style we all bastardize. Won every challenge twice. This man defines a chant. And now that your beard's going gray in this tantalizing patch, you fathered this entire scene and got the daddy vibes to match.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Tastiest condiment ever? Little salt with some pepper. Distinguished. You should be modeling cardigan sweaters, giving philosophy lectures. Even what you call yourself's clever blew my mind when I first saw it. Thesaurus, like the Saurus. How is no one else called this? Genius! Look at that smile. How can you not like this fucking dude? One glimpse of those shining pearly whites will brighten up your mood. He even charms you as he kills you. Gives you that tiny chuckle too. He'll light you up with bars while his smile is lighting up the room.
Wow.
You started around the same time as Mook. Both left the game recalibrated, but Mook's been coasting since. Just pops back in for us to validate him. You were always active, took any matchup. No hint of your talent faded. You've been behind bars for 20 years. And still beat the murder allegations. That's why you're a GOAT in every era. Your ability is timeless. So me saying that he sucks would be the silliest contrivance. I don't need fake disses just for syllables to rhyme with. I'm trying to prove I really am the nicest, so I'm killing you with kindness. He's not that nice. He's not that nice.
Wow.
He's not that nice.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well then, I'm good? Wow. Kill me with kindness? Fuck.
Let's go.
I was literally gonna spend this whole round saying I'd kill you in a drive-by. But now that I'm feeling half-baked, let's see who's really Mr. Nice Guy. As far as me fathering the scene, that part is totally true. I still remember the episode of Maury Povich when he broke me the news. Yo. Dog, you're so cool. There ain't nothing Alex Larson won't do. Fuck Dr. Scholes. Tom Cruise's mom couldn't walk in those shoes. He puts his friends in his movies because he's got a heart of gold, too. So I guess the only words left for him to hear are, and the Oscar goes to. But dog, hold up. Like, you really think you're nicer than me? Like, you are nicer than me? Dog, why are you lying to these people? Nicer than me. All right, Twist, why don't we see? Bartender, rest of the night, Twist drinks for the nighter on me. Woo. Now, what do you want? Long Island iced tea? Bottle of water, maybe a vitamin C. You've spent a lot of time on your feet tonight. Can I find you a seat?
Facts.
Facts. find you a seat? Oh, fuck. Can I find you a seat? If you told me that Kid Twist was a better writer than me, I would agree. Have you seen his fucking IMDb? He's written multiple episodes of Yasuke, which ain't exactly my cup of tea, but I still watched episodes 1 through 5 on repeat just on the off chance that you'd get a royalty or licensing fee. And I know you only wrote 4 episodes, but 5 was a better rhyme for the scheme. And you're too polite to correct me, which is fine as can be. Cause see, if I correct myself, then it really shows you guys what I mean when I try to explain that ain't nobody nicer than me. I haven't seen a single chick in here that old Twizzler won't fuck. Soon as he walks in the room, the bitches hold their mistletoes up. Right. Dog, if you leave battle rap again, I'll probably quit and go nuts. Cause these last 7 years without you here, I fucking missed you so much. Dog, I bet a biopic on Twist would be the sickest story. He's lived 1,000 lives at once like Rick and Morty. I could compliment you all night, but in a way that isn't corny. I would compliment your eyes, but that sweater already did it for me. Tom. You know? You ain't that nice. You know?
You! I bet you have the most athletic sex.
It's impressive.
Warm up with a calisthenic set. And put her in a pretzel stretch and do a full extension press for 20 reps. Lock in your targeting system so that rocket is hitting her G-spot with precision. Have her walking off limping because all of her limbs are wobbly and twitching. You turn an agnostic to Christian, she saw God for a minute. And for the kinky chicks, you've been putting chains up before Holahan did it. He's getting crazy trim. He's getting crazy trim. Your life's a movie that's made to win like the Fablemans, because when it comes to men pulling bad chicks, David Singh got his game from him. You're always pulling up with a new one and engaged again. Sure, marriage might have been nice, but if any of them deserved to actually cuff you, she would match your hustle and earn that ring twice.
Talk!
Plus, your daughter is the queen of your world.
Facts.
Can't buy her gifts fast enough. You spoil her worse than saying Joel dies in The Last of Us. Play the game.
Just watch episode 6.
Even Jesus wishes he had you instead of God for a father. Like, you see what Pete bought for his daughter? All I got was walking on water. But it's more about the talks when you call her, the moves you taught her in soccer. No trust fund, but you invested in that bond. Now you're watching her prosper. She's probably home right now watching Saw 3D. To write a 5,000-word essay on how Jigsaw represents the violence inherent in all carceral approaches to justice, even those which purport to serve a rehabilitative moral purpose, shit's getting an A easy. Your day job is playing poker. You're a high roller to the max. You gambled on your whole life and all you folded is your stacks. To beat those odds, imagine the cojones that he packs. Mm. This dude watches Uncut Gems and feels totally relaxed.
Fire.
He's even cool with opponents when he raps. Don't need compliments to boost their confidence enormous. They see you nod at their performance and buzz off of the endorphins. You're always putting others first. I know you caught some bitching for it, but those guys still bring up the cipher that they got in with the Solus. What an awesome human amongst me. Right? Right?
Let's go.
What an awesome human amongst me. Honest, proven, and trusty. Calm, cool, and cuddly. All-consumingly studly. Virile and mighty. So pure in his mind, he can peer in my eyes, and I can see the hero inside me.
What the fuck, bro?
Of course I had to flip Pat shit in tribute. His best bars were to diss you, and that's a bigger compliment than I could ever give you. Long live the king! Long live the king!
Wow! That was so fire. Wow! What an incredible round about me. For real, give him a hand. Give him a hand. Chubby Checker on the dance floor. I'm Twist's biggest fan. You could spend all three rounds telling me how big of a bitch that I am, and I'd still think you're Tom Hanks in Big. Kid is the man.
That's
fucking crazy. But Kid is way more than the man, and I know y'all can agree. And in light of him telling y'all how I fathered the scene, I thought I should be the first to tell y'all about some stuff that was brought up to me. Our kid here is all grown up now, and he's a father to be.
Let's go!
Dog, let's go. He's a father to be. That's the sonogram, see? It's got me glad right now. Got emotions that I can't tie down. Feel like I could cry tears of happiness for you for half my round. Cause our brother Pat is looking down from the clouds right now to say how proud he is you're about to be a dad right now.
Straight up, dog.
Let's go.
Dog, it is so fucking fire, dude. Is there anything I can buy for you? Fuck, it's a stroller, a cradle, a panoramic mural of the night and moon to light the room. Have you guys thought about baby names yet and what you're trying to do? I know what name I would choose. Patrick. But I'm also way more nice than you. So I am so stoked for your kid because I know how much love he'll get. Little genius will probably drop his first 30 right after his first couple steps. Now, having your first child is such a blessing. I don't want to sound unimpressed, but it also means congratulations on the tons of sex. And I just won a bet. I can't wait to tell your kid about the cool shit that his dad's done. Even though Frack might get a little jealous that now I got another grandson. Now, I didn't want to get personal with you because we don't have any personal issues. So I'm glad that a compliment battle is what you decided to turn this shit into. Because I would rather just show my homie here love after all of the shit that we've been through. So I got nothing but love for the kid. And I know you'll give the whole world to your kid too. Long live Pat Stay! We love you, we miss you.
Oh yeah.
You know?
Thank you, dog.
Thank you, bro. Woo. Oh, it's the best. Such a good. Oh my God. The last kid twist battle round.
Girthy.
He's got a point.
Bulbous. Colossal. Guess what I'm using a thesaurus for?
So fire. So fire.
Girthy. Bulbous. Colossal. Guess what I'm using a thesaurus for? The same thing every girl in here wants to be using a thesaurus for. That thing is like a 4x4. You can't fit your drawers in drawers.
Facts. Facts.
That thing is like a 4x4. You can't fit your drawers in drawers. These girls think less is more until they learn from Peter Morris more.
Fire! Fire! Fire!
Look, it's tough to be this well endowed. They don't see the disadvantage side. You send a girl a dick pic, and she can't handle the attachment size.
Fire.
And when you got the type of payload you do, these rappers dope to you. You listen to Guns So Big bars like, if they only
Let's go. Let's go. Wow.
In 05, you told Franco he looks like James Vanderbeek on 8 grams a tweet. And ever since, my brain's given that at least one playback a week. The moment, that multi and names fad, we all used to take that from Pete. I'll be the first to admit, my initial style was all thesaurus. I just used the same words with a twist. Let's return to 06. That's when I watched my first real battle, you and Justice. And in a matter of weeks, I signed up for the Proud to Be event where me and Organic would meet. Then came Jump Off, the title, trips to rap overseas, but still thoughts were nagging at me like I was the top draft in this league but could never match it with the stats I achieved. Wow. It made me doubt my whole path. Then I think back to when I watch your battles and dream and imagine how ecstatic I'd be to know I clashed the world rap champion team. And I'll always think about Alex and Patrick with grief, but I was honored to know them even though our moments were tragically brief. So fuck whether I'm a natural in this craft. This is a family retreat. My heroes became my brothers, and that's what matters to me.
Facts, bro. Fucking love you, dog.
Let's return to 06. That's when I watched my first real battle, you and Justice. And in a matter of weeks, I'd signed up for the Proud to Be event where me and Organic would meet. Then came Jump Off, the title, trips to rap overseas, but still thoughts were nagging at me like I was the top draft in this league but could never match it with the stats I achieved. Made me doubt my whole path. Then I think back to when I watch your battles and dream and imagine how ecstatic I'd be to know I clashed the world rap champion team. And I'll always think about Alex and Patrick with grief, but I was honored to know them even though our moments were tragically brief. So fuck whether I'm a natural in this craft. This is a family retreat. My heroes became my brothers, and that's what matters to me. If I could go back, I'd still enter Proud to Be a battle MC, because you're the reason I'm proud to be a battle MC. But back to his huge dick. Every time Pete gets a boner, it's indecent exposure.
Wow.
You glimpse it limp and think that he'd be a shower until you see he's a grower. You let it hang and it starts keeling you over. Funny, we're doing this for Pat Stay, and I'm with a man who has to wrap his leg around a 1,000-pound rattlesnake.
Bro.
And it's true. It's true, I'm about to be a father. So you were my rap inspiration, now you're my dad inspiration. Cause you fit with fatherhood more than khakis with Asics, classic Van Halen, or back inflammation.
Bro.
My son will know the right path when I raise him. So when he's like, Dad, you're the greatest. You shut your mouth, thesaurus is the goat. This damn generation. I know you came for a real battle. This is the realest battle I've ever had with Pete.
Facts.
And any format where we match up, it's a classic. That's the energy we keep. From Rich opening our Jump Off rounds to now, we've had a legendary streak. And history's a circle that just endlessly repeats. It all ends where it begins.
You should put me in body.
He did it, Joe!
So now the legacy is complete.
Rich was so
got you.
Like
got you.
Oh my God, I cannot
believe you did it. Make some noise for Kid Twist at the Thesaurus, yo!
That was so fucking fire, bro. I can't believe he did it. I can't believe he did it.
I want to thank every single one of y'all, not just y'all out there, but y'all up here, all the battle rappers that put on for this shit. Y'all the realest motherfuckers in this culture.
What a
real shit.
Weekend.
You guys mean the fucking world to me. Thank you so much for helping us complete this goal, making this come to life. None of this is possible without y'all. This is the house you guys built. This is the house that Pat built. It's only fucking right. When I say Pat stay, y'all say rest in peace.
I know, yeah.
Pat stay.
Rest in peace.
Pat stay.
Rest in peace.
Pat stay.
Rest in peace.
Forever. Good night.
I didn't get to see you.
Fucking love y'all, man.
I heard it was crazy.
We really just put together the most legendary weekend. That's what I'm going to be thinking about for a long time when I get home. We just put together the most, like, special, beautiful, historic weekend in battle history.
I don't know if I've ever actually written a genuine part of a rap battle before, but this was obviously the moment to do it. And I was just like, this is my chance to be really authentic. And then, you know, I snap back to the dick jokes, which was always part of the plan, because I'm like, that's the way to do it. And like, it's honoring Pat by being super real and then also honoring him by immediately going to dick jokes, which is also what he would do.
Oh God, his third especially. It was like so heartfelt when he's talking about the brotherhood that we all have. And when he said the line about still like the reason that he entered to be the tournament called Proud to Be a Battle MC is because I'm like, bro, it like shattered me being able to be like the first to be able to break the news to the public that he's going to be a dad too, which I'm like absolutely ecstatic about. Like, oh my God, bro, I'm like over the moon right now with how everything came out. I could not be happier. This whole weekend, it was the most beautiful weekend in battle rap history. There's no question about it.
Shit, I met Thesaurus in 2007. I remember, you know, obviously we, like, Rich and I battled him and Ilmac, and we didn't really talk to them before the battle. And then I remember we did a little bit probably just to say what's up. And then we walked out after, and they were like outside of the venue. And, you know, we just had this crazy battle. Might have even been after the second battle, and we just sort of saw each other, and we were the only guys outside, and we were just like, hey, and we all just stood around talking. We still have one more battle to do with them, but we all just like stood around talking. And yeah, man, that was like my initiation into the circle of battle rap. So I just always remember that, you know, Thesaurus has been like a pivotal person in my battle rap career I covered it in the battle, but just as a person as well. So to do that with him, I mean, yeah, it like I said, it kind of felt like fate in a way, you know, that we both had other things that were supposed to be lined up for this card, but this is the direction it went. Couldn't have been better.
He entered Scribble in the States, made the final eight against me. He made the fucking playoffs of WRC with Rich. Like, bro, Kid Twist is an undeniable legend. To be able to share his last battle with him, to be able to make it have a twist to it as well, where I get to big him up and like end it on that note. Oh, bro. And for this cause, like, it's everything, bro. It's fucking everything. It's the most special battle I could have ever done. Like, straight up.
So the surprise compliment battle is actually a concept that Pat had always wanted to do. So when we were planning this event, I always told Organic, like, look, I'm just, for whatever reason, I was thinking about, okay, I want to do a battle. I was trying to come up with just bars for people or general bars to see if I could still do it before I committed. And I wasn't coming up with anything, but I had all these compliments. I was thinking, okay, what if I do a compliment battle and bars would just start flowing? So I'm like, I'm in a compliment mind space. So let me try and do a compliment battle because that would be great on the pack card.
I think I was overthinking it at first. Like, well, fuck, I want to like tackle it in a way that isn't the typical compliment battle where it just goes super over the top, I'm in love with you type stuff. You know what I'm saying? Which is the route that they normally go. But I was like, I want to do something just slightly different than that. And then I realized like, oh, this is my boy. This is like, this guy's easy to compliment, you know? Twist is like a model citizen. Yeah. He's a fucking great dude.
And to hear that, it made people in the venue emotional. Like, I didn't know whether to expect that. Obviously, I was hoping that people would have some sort of response or reaction to what I was saying. So to get that, I mean, it's... you know, it's something special. It's something that's never happened to me in my rap battle career, because that's not usually the goal. But I'm glad that I was able to connect with the crowd like that on a different level.
We had every single battler had some sort of ill callback to a classic Pat moment in and made it their own and made it dope. And it was still recognizable to the point that it was a callback fully for the crowd. Like, bro, this event can never, like, something like this can just never be replicated. It can't.
I just want to say, you know, this was all for Pat's day. It was an honor to do it for him, for his family. And we love you, Pat. We love you.
This is something that, like, I am absolutely never going to forget for the rest of my life. I'm going to look back at every single piece of footage with, like, the most fond sentiments possible. It's just, it was a perfect fucking weekend. I don't think that's ever happened in battle history. Perfect weekend. Long live Pat Stay, man.
What up, suckers? Just a cat, you'll be here. Pat Stay. AKA Sucker Free Bonk. Packer Exo. Get me John's lunch, give me 445. You ready for this? Hell no, I got you covered. Fucking Gary, 29 years old. Pat Stay raps all the masterclass. Exaggerated bit, but Patrick saves the shit. I don't want to battle no more. I just want to relax.
Shuts down my dead homies. Suckers! I'm just joking. See ya!